Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo into Vexel artwork. Vexel art is a raster-based image that imitates the visual appearance of vector graphics, which have sharp-edged lines and areas of flat color or smooth gradient fills. The word itself is derived from a combination of vector and pixel. There's no one defined way to create a Vexel, and its look can vary from just two color outlines to pseudo-realism. Open a photo you'd like to use. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. To protect the original photo, it's always a good idea to make a copy of it. Press Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Next, we need to cut the subject from its background and place it onto its own layer. To do this, we first have to make a selection around the subject. There are many ways to make selections, so choose the method that works best for your particular image. Since this subject is on a white background, I normally would use the magic wand tool or color range, but if your subject isn't on a white background, we'll use the pencil tool for this example. Keep the hardness 100% and choose a small pixel size. Even though the size here is 10 pixels, keep in mind this amount will look smaller or larger on your image depending on the size and resolution of your photo. Make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard. Click the quick mask icon so we can draw in a quick mask. Draw around your subject. Drawing around the hair doesn't have to be perfect, since ultimately your image won't have any soft edges. When you've drawn around the entire subject, fill it in by opening your Paint Bucket tool and left-clicking on your subject. Press Q to make the quick mask into a selection and invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Press Ctrl or Command-J to cut your subject from its background and copy it to its own layer. Click the thumbnail of the middle layer to make it active. We're going to replace this layer with a solid color. Click the foreground color and pick a color that complements your subject. I'll click the lip to pick up its color and click OK. Notice the foreground is now the color you picked. To fill the layer with your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Next, we'll add a radial pattern on top of the color. Click the Custom Shape tool and open the Shape Thumbnails. Click the small gear icon to open your list of shape presets. Click Symbols, and when you see this warning, click OK to see just the symbols in the thumbnail window. Scroll down and click this icon, which is called Registration Target 2. Click the gear icon at the top, tick Define Proportions, and check From Center. Make sure there's no stroke. The icon for it is a red diagonal line. Click the color box and click the color picker icon. Left-click on a darker version of the color you picked earlier and click OK. Zoom out a little by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key. Go to the middle of your document and drag out the shape past the corners. To hide the paths, press Ctrl or Command H. To fit the document back onto your screen, press Ctrl or Command 0. Make the top layer active and rename it Poster Edges. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Poster Edges. Set all the attributes to 0 and click OK. Make a copy of the layer and rename it Smart Blur Edges Only. Go to Filter, Blur, and Smart Blur. Make the quality high and the mode Edges Only. The Edges Only mode finds the edges of color transitions where significant contrasts occur and creates an image of it of white lines on a black background. Drag the image to an area in the window where you can see the face. drag the radius and threshold to amounts that give just enough line detail. For this image, I'll set the radius at 2 and the threshold at 37. Press D to revert your foreground and background colors to black and white, and open your Paint Bucket tool. Make sure Contiguous is unchecked. If it is, uncheck it. I'll explain why in a moment. Left-click outside your figure. Notice all the areas surrounding the figure is filled in. I'll press Ctrl or Command Z to undo it. If Contiguous is checked, the Paint Bucket tool will only fill in areas that are connected. In this example, this area didn't fill in because the figure is disconnecting it. I'll undo it. As before, uncheck Contiguous and left-click outside the figure. Open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail next to RGB to make a selection of the white outline. Open back up the Layers panel and click off the eyeball of the top layer to hide it. Make a new layer above it by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-N. This window will appear. Name the layer Outlines and then click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with black, which is the foreground color. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Double-click the thumbnail of the Outlines layer to open its Layer Style window. Click Gradient Overlay. I'll leave it on Linear with an angle of 90 degrees. However, you can choose another style if you like. Click the Gradient bar and click a gradient preset you like. I'm choosing Spectrum. Then click OK on both windows. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.